You run from La Buca, but now you're running to come back. Running from La Buca, but now you're running to come back. So this was Drayton, and he was standing in the groan of morning. He was leaving the island behind, at least for now. Blue hills to fade, hills of hunters with flambeau blinking, the coast, the north, dense forest, green rivers, all that gone, water pass, business fix. He go settle for cold for now, metropolis, right. But first he had to flee. He had to flee from the home of his mistress. And she had poisoned his feet and poured lust into the corners of his eyes. She had wept crutch-wise to rice, sweat rice and wept. She had wept and swept her waters upon him. Put him with his shirt flung open to lie on the delicate bed of her sex, while the fern curtains billowed above. It was mid-afternoon, near the coast. This woman was washing her great breast in the sink. And in the valley below, the school bell rang out, and children began to fill the void. This poem was composed on the tip of the tongue. There were no mistakes, no errors of judgment, no rhythm that can fail. And since rhythm is a unit of meaning and a vision for which the road must be clear, the road must lean so slant that Drayton would find himself walking against its angle, touching the asphalt wall of the road for balance, looking down to quarry bone like walking around a mountain. But there was a straight road out of town, and in that town, Drayton joined an Easter parade. Someone threw him a bugle, and since he had long memorized the pentatonic scale, you see, a bugle can blow, but it can't blow flat. He found that he could play just by putting the horn to his mouth. Poison in his foot, and he is slipping, falling off the edge of the world. He saw the woman coming behind him, coming to come and crying, crying real tears. And she coming from El Salvador, and she coming from St. Kitts, and she coming from Grenada, and she coming from Peru, and she coming from Barbados. Look, she coming from Tobago. Look, she coming from St. Vincent. She coming from Guadeloupe. Look, she rolling under the ocean. Look, she coming from some foreign film. She has come barefooted straight from her bedroom. Her drawers are still twisted in her crutch, and she is pushing through the crowd to watch Drayton. But same old run, can't run dream sequence. So Drayton in his power paints his face black as a mask, and he runs sideways fastest through the parade. Well, imagine if a blade ridden in that woman's hand blade dipped so deep in oil it would leave marks in water. It would skin flesh to bone and back. The woman vexed. She wanted to bury Drayton jawbone in the desert for 7 days so the teeth would rattle in his jaw like charaska. But her palms and her tongue were both black with sin like scunya. She can't do right. But Drayton had loved her, and he'd even told her so. It was the last Sunday in June, and they were far inland, deep in wild country, La Boca. And she was bent over her enamel basin, rinsing with a rag reserved for washing. But by that time, what was even stranger was the fact that she had tried to cut Drayton's throat several times. And when he couldn't bear anymore to kiss the wrinkled mouth of her sex, Drayton vomit up vinegar and run. Well, look, you're running from El Salvador. You're running from Trinidad. Look, you're running from Brazil. Look, you're running from Suriname. And it saw Drayton end up in England. The man was just trying to change his life. Look, you're running from Belize. Look, you're running from Guyana. Look, you're running from St. Lucia. You're running from Dominica. Look, you're running from La Boca. Running from La Boca. You're running from St. Kitts. Look, you're running from St. Vincent. Look, you're running from Trinidad. Look, you're running from La Boca. From La Boca now, you're running to come back. Look, you're running from La Boca, but now you're running to come back.